Looking back into the history of warfare, we have brought many advancements in this area. From mechanical guns to the current prototypes of robot soldiers, defense tech is being upgraded every day. Well, you might be surprised in knowing how far we have advanced in destroying ourselves. But let's cut the cliche moral value session of why we shouldn't build these things, and let's dig into the topic of what China has been building this whole time. Feeling excited? Let's get straight into it. Hey folks, my name is Alex, and welcome to the AI News Daily. For daily videos, please consider subscribing to our channel and make sure to turn on the notifications. Without further ado, let's head into the video. Yes, as we were talking, China has been on its mission to develop some kind of concealed form of underwater AI robots capable of attacking enemy ships with torpedoes without human guidance. China has been one of the most ambitious countries, but at the same time, maintained extreme secrecy with its function occurring inside the country. But what they have done now has shaken its rivals. These devices, also termed unmanned underwater vehicles, or UUVs, were formulated in the experiments which were being conducted over a decade ago and have now successfully managed to use artificial intelligence to locate a target submarine and ambush it with a torpedo missile. The experiments conducted in the Taiwan Strait, a contested body of water that Beijing claims, with the island as its own, showed the UUV being deployed on a fixed course almost 30 feet beneath sea level. The vehicle was able to recognize the location of the dummy submarine, shift its course towards the submarine, circle the target, and then fire at the sub with an unarmed torpedo. This UUV used usual sonar and onboard detectors to retrieve data, which were evaluated and assessed by the computer to help it finalize the task and fire right at the target. This oddly timed announcement came right after China warned Japan against its offering to unite its forces with the US military to protect Taiwan. A viewpoint section in the Global Times asserted that Japan was digging its own grave by proposing to uphold Taiwan from China by fighting alongside the US. The story also explained that Japan was helpless against the Chinese military and advised it not to pass over Beijing's red lines. The UUVs are already being wielded by commercial shipping businesses and navies, but they have never been employed in combat. And not just that, several UUVs have been washed up on numerous coasts in Asia. In December, Indonesian fishermen found a 2-meter unmanned underwater drone lying near Seliyar Island, just off South Sulawesi. The device was revealed to authorities 6 days later. Pictures disseminated in local media showed Indonesian military officers standing along with a long gray drone, specified as a Chinese Haiyi, or Sea Wing. The high-tech, unpowered supervision device is known as a glider. It employs variable buoyancy propulsion tech to analyze the waters. Local media explained that the drone was in the pattern of a missile and, made out of aluminum, was 225 centimeters in length with a 50-centimeter wing on its side. And a rear antenna connected to the equipment is also 93 centimeters in length. The investigations about the UUV equipment were illustrated in papers composed by researchers at the Harbin Engineering University in 2010 and were declared openly last week. Scientists, led by Professor Liang Guolong, state that the needs of future underwater warfare give rise to new advancement alternatives for unmanned platforms, especially in AI. He also added that the UUVs, which are likely to be developed since 2010, could be programmed to be utilized in a faction and make concurrent attacks on a single target. That's some impressive stuff. And unlike human-guided launchers, these would be accurate, precise, and undoubtedly wouldn't wait for approval on noticing an unidentified vessel. Yup, boom! And one wouldn't even get the time to realize that he is about to get hit. So, what's the stand of other countries towards this upgrade of China? Let's see. Using artificial intelligence isn't common to most of the countries in the world. Many of them are presently utilizing this tech in warfare, particularly in locating and striking enemy drones and battalions. Countries like Israel have employed an AI-guided drone swarm to accomplish its assaults on Hamas militants, which is believed to be a world first. In May, the Israeli Defense Force, or IDF, support unit deployed the swarm to encounter Hamas militants who allegedly blasted rockets into Israel grounds. Drones are generally steered by a human operator, but these drone swarms are a step ahead in military technology. they glide as one merged network of drones governed by artificial intelligence. The flock employs only one human operator to authorize the drones before they find the marks. An IDF chief notified the local news media that the swarm unit has already carried out more than 30 victorious operations. The force intends to make more of these drone swarms ready to support the force. Another example of this is from the US Navy. This is Orca, an autonomous underwater vehicle, or AUV, currently being developed by Boeing for the US Navy. The Orca project dates back to September 2017, when the Navy handed out contracts worth nearly $40 million each to Boeing, which had merged earlier in the year with HII to build unmanned submarines, and Lockheed Martin to develop competing designs for an extra-large unmanned undersea vehicle, or XLUUV, which are capable of conducting autonomous operations during its missions. The vessel will be powered by a hybrid diesel-lithium-ion battery system, which fuels the Orca by the battery while being submerged and recharges the batteries with diesel generators while surfaced. The claimed maximum speed is 8 knots, or 15 kilometers per hour. Though the typical service speed is about 3 knots, or 5.6 kilometers per hour, which gives the vessel a span of up to 6,500 miles with vigor for several months. Well, this vast use of drones has triggered anxiety among nations, and governments at the United Nations have been disputing for months on whether a common global pact should be approved on the practice of armed drones, autonomous and otherwise, and what regulations should be cited over them. This concern was mainly placed over the incident, which occurred in Libya last year. Western military experts are examining whether an autonomous drone administered by artificial intelligence, or AI, killed people for the first time without a human operator authorizing it remotely to do so. An article by the United Nations panel of specialists handed out last week concluded the advanced drone deployed in Libya was hunted down and remotely engaged by the soldiers who fought for the Libyan general Khalifa Haftar, has also prompted a frantic discussion among Western security officials and critics. The UN's Libya allegation is adding necessity to the controversy. If these AI drones did take off a lethal swarm attack, it would underline a different chapter in autonomous weapons. Critics of AI drones, which can use facial recognition technology, assert that they extend a number of moral, ethical, and legitimate difficulties among countries. With this, we have come to the end of the video. Please drop your suggestions in the comment box below about what all topics would you like to see on our channel. And did you find our video interesting and beneficial? That's about it for today. Make sure to subscribe to our channel for more content just like this one. And while you're at it, turn on post notifications so that you never miss out on any of our future uploads. Drop a like for the video if you're a huge fan of AI and the advancements they make every day. That's it for today. Hope you enjoyed the video. We will meet again in the next one.